Good morning to all. Good morning to all participants connected with this 5 days international webinar series. Today's session going to present by Dr. V. Satish Kumar sir. Dr. V. Satish Kumar sir working as assistant professor in Department of Manufacturing Engineering, and he qualified his PhD in the area of fracture mechanics and acoustic emissions. He specializes in the area of operational research, foundry technology. He has very vast experience in academic, and he is a nice person. He is guiding more number of PhDs in various areas. Today, our resource person, Dr. V. Satish Kumar sir, going to present in the topic of advancement in composite materials. On behalf of our management, principal, and the Department of Mechanical Engineering, and participants, and my own behalf, I am very happy to welcome our resource person, Dr. V. Satish Kumar sir. Welcome you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Next, I am very happy to welcome all the participants, because all the participants give you a wonderful support for the past 4 sessions. On behalf of our management, principal, and my own behalf, I very much happy to welcome all the participants. I request all the participants kindly attend the entire webinar session and give your valuable feedback, feedback at the end of our feedback line. Once again, I welcome you all. Now I hand over the session to our resource person, Dr. V. Satish Kumar sir.
Thank you. So, good morning, one and all present here for the 5 days webinar series. It's conducting by the St. John's College of Engineering and Technology, Angusuttipalayam, Pandruti. So I am Dr. V. Satish Kumar, assistant professor, Annamalai University. Now I am deputed to the Government College of Engineering, Salem. I am working as a assistant professor in Department of Mechanical Engineering, GCE, Salem. So my topic today is advances in composite materials. The content of this topic, what is composite, classification of composite material, characteristics of composite material, basic calculation, how to add the materials, and the metals versus composite, what are the difference between these two, and developing trends and design consideration of composite and recent advancements. See, first you'll see the what is meant by composite. You know that composite is made up of minimum of two components adding together to constitute a material that will have the different physical and chemical properties. These properties are combined together, but only thing is, after manufacturing this in a structural component, that is, you can see the separate and distinguished phases individually in the composite. When you are cutting into the material, you can see that separate and distinguished phases in the material inside. So that is the difference between the composite material and alloy. Okay. Why you use to composite? Because it has high stiffness and high strength, high Young's modulus, high fracture strength, especially at the elevated temperatures. Say the example of ceramic materials, it is very useful in the elevated temperature. Then high corrosive resistance, low density, that is a very, very important property, this low density, high thermal and electrical conductivity, and high wear resistance. How these properties are incorporated in a material in the working condition, we will see in the later on slides. The composite, I have given two same images to understand what is the composite. So this is basically first one, the left side is a aluminium matrix SiC composite. You have that aluminium matrix that will give the shape of the composite, and SiC is a particle. So that particle will add into the matrix. So this rounded particles, the porosity and inclusions will be there in any of the material. So this is the aluminium metal matrix composite, is the left side one. And right side, the epoxy matrix and for bamboo fibers, reinforcement is a bamboo fibers. So with this, we can move on to the next slide. Matrix material. So matrix is nothing but a matrix binds the either the fiber or particle, provide the component shape and the surface quantity. So that will give the shape. So this matrix is widely in the four categories. One is polymer matrix composite, metal matrix composite, ceramic matrix composite, and carbon matrix composite. So that will give the shape of the material, as well as this is the base of the material. Then reinforcement. Reinforcement constituents in composite provide the strength, comma, heat and corrosion resistance, etc. So this will give the more property when you are adding this reinforcement, either in the form of particle or fiber, that will give the strength, extra strength to the composite material. So this reinforcements aligned in a four categories in the form of continuous fibers. The continuous fiber means it's like a thread. So the L by D, length by diameter ratio, is very, very more. So we cannot give the numbers. So it's like a stitching thread, that is the called continuous fibers. And discontinuous fiber is minimum of L by D ratio is 100. So length by diameter is ratio is 100. When you are cutting into the continuous fibers, you can get a discontinuous fibers. Then third form is viscous. It is elongated crystals. Say the L by D ratio is less than 100, is equal to viscous. Then next is particle. This particle is less than 1 micrometer size, all are called particles. These are added to the matrix material. This will provide the superior quality, like stiffness, strength, toughness and all. This is the reinforcement forms. We can add this reinforcement in A is the continuous fiber, B is the discontinuous fibers. When you are cutting and mixing into that, we can see the same images of figure B that will show the discontinuous fiber. So viscous, the L by D ratio is less than 100. Then you can cut into that mix into the matrix, that will give the viscous. Then fourth one is the particle. You are adding the material 1 micrometer, less than 1 micrometer, you are adding, that is the particle with the matrix, that is the D, that is the reinforcement forms. In types of composite material, I told you that matrix and reinforcement. So matrix is a polymer, reinforcement is also can be a polymer. Either matrix is a metal, reinforcement is a polymer. Matrix is a ceramics and reinforcement is the polymer. Like that, you can make a combination on that. So using that, so many combinations, depending upon the requirement, we can make a composite based on this category. Okay. So this is the types of composites. Then classification of the composite. I already told you that it's in a matrix type. We can have the four types: metal matrix, polymer matrix composite, ceramic matrix composite, carbon matrix composite. So in this metal matrix composite, this is the oldest required method. We can add the materials like aluminium, copper, nickel, titanium. So aluminium is the base metal, and you can add into the additional metal which you want for your practical purposes. Then you are adding that, the metal matrix. So this metal matrix play the vital role. See, it is the application wise, it is used in the electrical towers, and the electrical wires, instead of copper wires, we can use the metal matrix wires. That wires doesn't have the sagging problem. So that sagging problem will minimize the number of towers in the working condition. So in that way, that having the huge potential in the electrical department. In the sports, we can use the rockets, tennis rockets and all. That is made by the metal matrix composite. That is very lighter and weight because the density is low. So very lighter and weight, they can use it in the sports materials. And then coming to the day-to-day activities, like a cycle, in olden day cycles, they had the weight of more than 10 kgs. So we thought that huge weight cycles are the very reliable one. But nowadays, the aluminium matrix composite cycles are very, very low weight. Is entire weight of the cycle is 3 kg, but it is equal to the steel cycle of more than 10 kgs. So the performance is like that. So that much huge potential in the metal matrix composite. Then coming to the polymer matrix composite, polymer matrix have the thermoplastic, thermosets, and the elastomers is there, one more is there. So thermoplastics is a good stiffness character, and comparatively thermosets is more higher stiffness factor compared to this one, but it having some drawbacks. Thermosets having some drawback in there. Then elastomers is the third category of the polymer matrix. So elastomers is a wide range of application of rubbers. This is having very high ductility, say even 200% ductility. It is you can make a component from rubber band to aeroplane tires. So that much application oriented property is there. In the thermoplastics, we can use the thermoplastic material as nylon, polypropylene, and these are the examples are quoted here. And thermosets, polyester, vinyl ester, epoxy, phenolex. So these are the some example of the materials. So I told you that thermosets having some drawbacks. That drawbacks is nothing but that will have the recyclable problem, but thermoplastics not having that problem. But thermosets having the advantages is that it is working in an elevated temperature. So that is the greater advantages of thermosets. Then ceramic matrix composites. So ceramic matrix composites, so initially ceramics is a brittle material. So that things can be eliminated by the ceramic matrix composite by adding the glass and the cement. So you can eliminate the brittle character, and it can be used in the very elevated temperature material. This is ceramic matrix. Then carbon matrix. So the carbon matrix. So carbon-carbon properties are very, very high. The maximum of the aeroplane noses are produced by the carbon-carbon composites, because when this changes the attitude from high to low level, the nose will experience huger amount of pressure as well as the temperature changes that can be withstand by the carbon matrix. So these are the overall classification about the composite matrix. Next, we move on to the reinforcement. So classification of the reinforcement composite materials are viscous reinforcement, particle reinforcement, fiber reinforcement, and the structural. So viscous, I told you that it is L by D ratio is very small. Cut into that fiber, we can mix it. That is a mixed with the composite material. That is a viscous reinforcement. particle reinforcement, the ranges of the particle is minimum or maximum of 1 micrometer. So we can vary the size of the particles. So based on the size, can have the large particle and disperses synthon particle as a very small particles. So in that way, you can get a two combinations, large particle and disperses synthon. In fiber reinforcement, the either it is a continuous or short fiber or hybrid fiber. So in this continuous fiber, there is an uniaxial direction and biaxial direction. The fibers are arranged in a one direction or more than one direction. So that is the difference. We have the continuous fibers. Then short fibers, you can make so many arrangements, aligned or random. Then hybrid, the hybrid fiber is nothing but more than one fiber is arranged in a composite to make a hybrid composite, that is oblique and orthogonal fibers. And the structural fibers, we have the laminate and the sandwich. So you know that laminate, the seeds are produced in the wood sheets are produced in the laminate, the sandwich. So mixed of powders in one layer, then laminate sheet is in another layer. In that way, we can get it a sandwich structural components. So in this, in the fiber reinforced composites play the major role in this industry. These are some of the natural fibers is in existing format. So first one is left side top corner is loofah. So loofah is a vegetable. So from that you can get it a fiber, that is the loofah fiber, and below that it is banana fibers and the chicken feather fibers and the sisal fibers, and top one is palm fibers, then rice husk, then cotton fibers, flax fibers, jute, kenaf, coir, abaca, hemp, and rami. So the loofah is a vegetable. Then you know that banana. So banana, from the banana tree, we can extract the banana fiber. Then third one is chicken feather. And the fourth one is sisal. The sisal is normally in the dry places. You can get it as and purify that. You can get a sisal fiber. So palm, the palm tree, from that we can get as the palm fiber. Then waste of the rice is called a rice husk. So you can add it to the natural fiber. And cotton, you know, the flax, the seeds, we know the flax seeds from there. That plant, you can get a flax fiber. And the jute. And the kenaf and abaca, these are rami. These three are Chinese products. It's normally that vegetables, that plants are available in the Chinese country. Then jute, we know, everyone know that. And the coir, this is from the coconut tree. And the hemp, these are all the eatable product, hemp. So the hemp waste, we can make it as the hemp fiber. So with this, we can move to the next, artificial fibers. These fibers, the natural fibers, say added to the matrix, you can get a different composition of the composite. Beyond this, this palm tree having the palm seeds, that can be crushed into the small particles. That is also now added into the material. They can produce the composite. Like that groundnut waste, groundnut shell also crushed and making the composite. That's nowadays in the research work. Then synthetic fibers. So synthetic fibers, first one is carbon, then basal fiber and glass fiber and Kevlar fiber. So the Kevlar is the most superior quality fiber. It is used in the aeronautical applications and other main industries are using in the Kevlar fibers. Then characteristics of composite material. We know that composite is strongly heterogeneous material. So the properties varying point by point are depending upon the which metal phase is there. So based on that, either you can direction wise the property changes, otherwise what are the orientation, that also the plays the major role in the strength. So that's why it's normally composite have the heterogeneous property. How this heterogeneous property is converted into useful work, that is the design thing of the composite material. So the property of a composite vary considerably from the point to point in a material depending upon which material phase the point is located. Then we are making the artificial components, especially reinforcement component. So the reinforcement, once you are added the reinforcement, the properties varies with the direction. That property, the orientation of the fiber based on the property is there. That's why it is called anisotropy. When the structural is made, the artificial fibers, say the example of wood carrying load in more than one direction, that's why the plywood is laminated. So that will having the more than one direction load it carries that. So that is the characters of composite. Next, the particle composites are isotropic. So isotropic in sense equilaxed, that is strength is in three direction are same, because the particle composites, the particles are distributed evenly, so that the particle composite having isotropic property. Many reinforcement composite, especially polymer matrix, metal matrix and carbon matrix composites are doesn't have the plastic behavior property. It means that it will not a brittle material. So this is different from the brittle and the plastic behavior, especially in the composite material. That means that it's sensitive to concentration, sensitive to stress concentration. Where the stress point is more, the particular point it get a failure. So that is the sensitive to stress concentration, sensitive to stress concentration. So this absence of brittle, the absence of plastic behavior means that it will won't behave a brittle manner. Okay, so these are the thing in the polymer matrix, metal matrix and the ceramic matrix composites. Then heterogeneous nature, the composite gets failure. It's complex failure mechanism. So the complex failure mechanism is says that the previous slide I told that it will not a brittle failure. Where the stress concentration point is there get the failure. So the fiber reinforced material have been found to produce durable and reliable structures. Durable and reliable structures. So that they are durable in the sense it's you can apply the load in every direction that can withstand. So that the way you can tell us the durable. The unique character of composite material, especially anisotropic, require to use of special design method. That is necessary. The component should have the special design, then it can withstand for more loads. So this is the fiber orientation. Earlier we discussed that fiber orientation plays the major role. So it means that the fiber orientation of first one is inclined, next one is changed, like that we can make a orientation. In this orientation, how it is played, we can see that the effect of fiber orientation on the tensile strength of E-class fiber reinforced epoxy composites are presented here. Here the axis angle between the fiber and the stress, Y is the tensile strength in MPa. When you are making that fiber in 90 degree orientation, the tensile strength will have between the 70 to 120, 130. That's all. When you are changing the direction from 90 to 60, you are shifted to that, the property increases from 120 to 220 like that. Then you are shifting that into 45, it vary from 200 to nearly 300. When you are shifted further into 30 degree, it is from 250 to 370 it will get. When you are making that zero orientation, it is more than 100 megapascal. That much of variation in the orientation, you can get a property of the material. So this is the one of the example. So this, in the similar way, you can get a, any of the fiber, the strength will vary depending upon the orientation of the fiber. So this is the crisp slide. Physical properties of mostly composite materials are anisotropic and heterogeneous. So this is different properties in different direction, different properties at different locations. These are the property of the composite material. Then basic calculation. So our requirements, we have to add the material. Say example, we're going to manufacturing the aluminium metal matrix composite. You are adding that another element of silicon carbide. So the silicon carbide, in what percentages you have to add is, you can add in the volume fraction or weight fraction. Weight fraction or volume fraction. So in this volume fraction, so volume fraction of the material is volume fraction divided by the volume of the composite. See, here I have taken as a fiber as example. Either in the particles, we can take it as, and that way, the volume fraction of the particle VF is equal to volume of the particle divided by the volume of the composite. In the fiber wise, volume fraction of the fiber is equal to volume of the fiber divided by the volume of the composite. So volume of the matrix fraction is small VM is equal to volume of the matrix divided by volume of the composite. So adding these two fractions, volume fraction of the material matrix and volume fraction of the fiber, that's equals one. So volume of the composite equal to volume of the fiber plus volume of the matrix, that is equal to composite volume. This is the weight fraction. Fiber weight fraction is weight of the fiber divided by the weight of the composite. Then weight of the matrix fraction is equal to weight of the matrix divided by weight of the composite. The same way you can get it. In the 5% example of, you are adding 5% of silicon carbide, means 95% of aluminium, 5% of weight percentage of silicon carbide. In that way, you are adding that. So the weight of the composite is equal to 5% silicon carbide plus 95% of the aluminium. So this is the simple calculation you should know. And the density, you know that density is nothing but volume by weight by volume. Weight by volume. So weight of the composite is equal to weight of the fiber plus weight of the matrix. So density of the composite into volume of the composite is equal to density of the fiber into volume of the fiber plus density of the matrix plus volume of the matrix. So you can get a, you want to find the density of the composite is equal to density of the fiber into volume fraction of the fiber plus density of the matrix into volume fraction of the matrix. So the small VF means that small VF is nothing but capital VF divided by capital VC. So VF is volume fraction, that is volume of the fiber divided by the volume of the composite. So that is called a rule of mixture. aqua density. This is the simple thing. You want to know, add the materials. This is the longitudinal stress, strength and stiffness. So when you are in a composite, you are loading that. Either it may be a fiber or matrix or composite. The fiber or matrix are feeling that same strain. No strain changes at all. So that's why strain of the fibers equal to strain of the matrix equal to strain of the composite. But the load sharing is total load is composite load is equal to fiber load plus matrix load. That sharing is there. So the fraction of the load carried by the fiber, the load of the fiber divided by load of the composite is equal to Young's modulus of the fiber into velocity of the fiber divided by the Young's modulus of fiber into velocity of the fiber plus Young's modulus of matrix into volume of the matrix. So the strain doesn't changes, the load carrying capacity only changes for the material. The reinforcement distributes some weight, share the well load, and matrix will share some load. When we compare the metals and the composites, compare the metals and composites, we can compare the four properties: weight, thermal expansion, specific stiffness, and specific strength. So already we discussed the density wise composite having the low density, so that weight also very reduces. So compare, why are comparing that steel and aluminium with the composite? The steel and aluminium is the playing their major role in the material section. The steel is replaced by the aluminium. Nowadays the aluminium is replaced by the aluminium composites. So that is the difference. Then nowadays is going up, so that comparatively it is one third of the, more than one third of the weight reduction can be get it in the composite. Compared to the aluminium, composite has a little less weight. Then thermal expansion. So aluminium having more thermal expansion, even the composite doesn't have the expansion at all. The steel having the half of the aluminium level thermal expansion is have. And this most two important factors of specific stiffness and specific strength. So specific stiffness is very, very higher compared to the steel and aluminium. Same thing is happening in the specific strength. So specific stiffness is nothing but stiffness. Specific stiffness is nothing but Young's modulus of the material divided by the density. So that is the specific stiffness. Specific strength is a ultimate tensile strength divided by the density of the material. So that these are the very, very important property of the specific stiffness and specific strength according to the composite is concerned. So steel and aluminium is very, very low specific stiffness, as well as the specific strength also is comparatively one third it is reduced. Next, developing trends and design considerations of composite. The need for developing composite for use in high performance structural and functional application. These two applications are very significantly rising recently. Why? The combination of low density, improved stiffness, and high strength. This makes the change to overcome the limitations of the existing alloy. This developing trends, why are occurring? This low density, the improved stiffness, and high strength only, they are changing the existing alloy. So it is raised significantly. The survey says that every year the usage of composite is increasing. Is 5% year wise, and especially in the fiber reinforcement composites, it's erasing 12% of the revenue. Say that developing trends in design consideration composites improve the design procedure and reliability and performance. So this design procedure only will used to select the material based on that reliability, you can achieve that will give the good performance of the material. This can be achieved by reducing either absolute weight or increase in strength to weight ratio. The strength to weight ratio, we can discuss in the automobile sector. In the automobile sectors, the lightweight will give the high fuel efficiency of the vehicle, as well as it will give the high speed. It produces the high speed of the engine. So these things are very important factor of the as considered as the automobile industry. For this purpose, the material of high ultimate tensile strength, high stiffness, high yield strength, and low densities are useful to developing this composite material. This is the global market, metal matrix composite market, Research Moss Global Private Limited, given this chart. And this chart is between that 2012 to 2019. The x-axis is volume in tons, revenues in US dollars, millions, and y-axis is the volume in tons. In the year of 2012, it is 5,496.4 tons of volume they are produced. From that, get a revenue of 228.7. It continuously increases in every year. Approximately 5% per year is increases. And finally, now the 2019, it has reached more than 370 US million dollars revenue. And volume wise, nearly 8,000 tons. Nearly 8,000 tons. So this will source that how much important of the composite, how much revenue it is developed from that composite and all. Okay. Growth in composite industry. The previous graph tells that story. Why this is has happened in that? The people are making the hybrid composites, and then so that it can be replaced the existing material. So the growth is more, and from that revenue is more. The global competition makes the market in growing at 5% every year, with the carbon fiber demand growing 12% per year. That is the important case. So that it continuously increasing every year by year. The application wise, application of the composites, turbine blades, high performance braking system, gas fired burner pots, refractory components, hot press dies, thrust control flaps for jet engines, insulation in small arm weapon platform, rocket propulsion components, turbojet engine components, combustion liners for glass turbine engines. This is the application for polymer matrix composite. Automotive vehicles, aerospace vehicle, marine vehicles, medicine devices, footwears, sporting goods, industrial equipment, packing, impellers, blades, housing, and covers, energy storage devices. So in this automobile vehicles, it's a varieties of vehicles are there. So the medical devices also. Why the medical devices? This medical devices is used in a very corrosive environment, because body fluid is coming into contact with that, that can react. So the normal metals which doesn't withstand the body fluid material, so that the medical devices are manufactured by the composites. Like that, every product, sporting goods and footwears, because of the low density they are using the composite material. I have quoted here some of the fibers and matrix. These are the components to produce the application wise material. So the carbon fibers matrix is a metal or ceramics can make the lightweight automotive fuel cells, sports goods like graphite fibers, gas tanks, aircraft, wind turbines. The matrix is a polyesterine. Then sisal fibers, using the sisal fiber, the matrix is a polypropylene, PP. Application, automobile, body parts, roofing, seats. Hemp fiber, polyethylene. The furniture and automobile, Kinaf. So polylactic acid is a matrix. The application is bearing automotive parts. Flax, polypropylene is the matrix. The structural and the textile applications. Remi, this is the natural fiber from the Chinese country. The polypropylene is the matrix, and using that they can produce the bulletproof vest. The waste of rice husk fiber can produce the polyurethane matrix. Using that we can produce the windows, door frames, automotive structures. Using the jute fibers, matrix is the polyester. Application wise, it's used as a roofs, rope, door panels. Coir, from that coir, you know that using that plain coir matrix we can get a bed. Nowadays there are many beds are coming with the coirs. So the coir matrix is a polypropylene. The automobile structures, components and roofing seats. I told you that a bed is matrix is a coir, fiber is also coir that can be manufactured by the bed. So these are the some of the examples. Using that fibers we can get the application wise. So based on our requirements we can make it as you can make a which fiber and matrix can go for the application. So this is the examples. The aircraft roofing structures maximum say is 90%. 90% of the components are roofing components are changed from the material to component, material to composites. This figure shows that how the material is replaced, normal material is replaced with the composite. So the blue in color is the glass reinforcement composite, and the white in color is aluminium composite, green in color is the Kevlar composite. I told you that Kevlar is a very strong material, so that is why it is placed in the noses. Then the gray in color is a carbon composite. See, almost 90% of the roofing component of the LCA Tejas aerospace application vehicle will have the all the material of composites. Then sports cars and motorcycles. Nowadays frequently the door panels and then the roofing seats and the side seals and all, they are coming from the matrix component, so that it can be replaced. It can be reduces the weight of the total weight of the car or vehicle, so that will give the greater efficiency of the vehicle. So using the fiber reinforcement composite, especially in the fiberglass reinforcement composite, is very very useful for the corrosive environment. So the figure shows the tank using the composite with a right fiber and resin makes for structural that survive in corrosive environment. So no material withstand with the high corrosive environment. So only alternative is that composite, fiber reinforced composite. In the aeroplanes, their bodies are maximum used by the composite material because the radar cannot transmit and receive through the metals such as aluminium used on the rest of the on an aeroplane. So that maximum component of the aeroplane is reduced, changed because of the this reason only. Then the traditional method of cars will not change the design because the curves and all is a problem while changing the design. But the near net shape product of the composite method is one of the method of near net shape, so that they can that eliminates the traditional method, which changes we want we can make it as using the composite. So this is the example: add flair and distinct to the design or part not always found with traditional materials. Composite is doing that. And this is a bathtub, the best example of fiber glass reinforcement. So it's a bathtub. Previously this is made up of steel. Now it is coming with the fiber glass, the lower cost, and it cannot having the scale formation, cannot have the corrosive problem at all. It is prepared by the lower end cost. Then this is the adjustable properties of composite, making an ideal material for creating complex and unique shapes. So previously the complicated shapes are manufactured through the casting methods. So casting had a problem of thickness. When it should have some thickness only the strength can be withstand in the material. So this panel, the guitar panel, is complicated in shape. It's very small, minimum amount of thickness can be tailor made by the composite. So that is possible only for the composite. Then this is the helmet with having the bulletproof property. So that is, you can adjust the size of this helmet also, depending upon the head size and the face size, you can make it a alignment. So that is the unique strength of the composite. Then this assembly, the car assembly, is having a more number of parts in a particular place. The total thing, small things are replaced by the entire assembly, by reassembled by the individual component. We can call it as a integrity of parts. So that can be achieved through the composite material. This is the automotive panel, JEC 2016 Tejas. It's developed by the deep draw method. This is a thermoplastic. This lengthy panels is having a good stiffness characters that can be very small thickness. This can be prepared by the thermoplastics. This is the Airbus roofing structure of thermoplastic composite. In this process, steps ribs are inserted and welded to the inner skin of the leading edges. So the imagine the length, the huge length. There's they are welding the ribs and all. Just you can put it as a holding point. This is the Airbus A387. This is the helicopter drive shaft. This is carbon fiber. It proved the mechanical capability of the thermoplastic composite and performed exceptionally well in the high speed projectile test. This was developed by Automated Dynamics. This is a helicopter drive shaft. Not only this thing, we previously discussed that ceramic metal matrix composites are useful to the elevated temperature. That means that it replaces the super alloy material. This is successful. 73 hours jet engine was tested in the Rolls-Royce 1000 jet aircraft engine. Ceramic metal matrix composites providing advantages not only in the engine hard section but is in all also in other applications previous dominated by the super alloy metals source Boeing. This is the figure of that component. Next, aerospace. Here the helicopter having the black in color is carbon plus glass fiber, then green in is only glass, and orange color is Kevlar and blue in color is carbon fibers. So this is another replacement of the material to composite. Composite allows for the material properties such as stiffness, strength and density. See here, the robo is tailoring the component of the fiber reinforcement. The lengthy fiber is coming like a tailoring machine that stitches the component with the matrix. So that's the component is preparing. There is the latest technology. So the advantages are smaller dimensional accuracy, tight tolerance, repeatable molding, chemical resistance, corrosion resistance, design flexibility, durable, high impact strength, high performance at elevated temperature. These are the main advantages of the composite. Then we are moving into the recent advances. So these recent advances is very helpful to the those who are starting the research or going to do the research. You can go for this and apply. Multifunctional composite and novel microstructure. The properties of the composite material can be tailored through microstructural design. So how we are doing the test in the miniature level like that. See in the CAD model and all, we are testing that. What is the strength? Not preparing the component previously, we are doing the test so that in that manner the microstructural level they are making the design changes in the micro scale and nanostructural level. This novel approach creates and controls the inhomogeneity of the reinforcement distribution. I told you that reinforcement direction plays the role. No, that can be controlled by this microstructural design. Though so the inhomogeneity is eliminated here, you can get a good composite. That is a multifunctional composite novel microstructure. And the shaped fibers, normally the circular fibers are used. Currently the circular fibers are using, so the thickness can vary, the improve the fracture toughness of the material. Why means the between it makes the bonding between the fiber and matrix based on the shape only, it gets the binding. So in the round fiber, the circular fiber having the discontinuity point in the pasting and all. So while it is in the thickness wise can vary it, you can change the shapes, the fracture toughness of the component as increases. So this is also one of the important advances. Then self healing. Impact damage to composite structure can result in a drastic reduction in mechanical property. So this impact damage, how they are rectifying that? In the structural, they are inserting the hollow fibers. Hollowing fibers are inserting that. So generate the healing effect. Both the composite laminate and the sandwich structures. That is, you can do it in a already structural, you can do it in this. So insert the hollow fibers and generate healings. so that after that you can give the storage reservoirs to having the bleeding mechanism. So it supplies the biological organisms to the material from the reservoirs. It curing the composite problems. Then the cracks arrest the and recover the structure. After that, we can simply go for the inspection process, and subsequently, its permanent damage is there. You can repair it. So this is the self-healing method regarding the hollow fibers, and you are supplying the bleeding mechanism of biological organisms to cure the product where it is maybe cracked. That crack may be arrested, then it can continue the services. It is a self-healing. Fiber reinforced dental resins. The dental doctors are using to mix the composite talcs with polymethyl methacrylate. Polymethyl methacrylate is a gum. They are adding that. So like a talcum powder, they are having the composite material. They are adding it into this material. Then preparing the to solve the cavities problem and filling the dental problems and all. So once again, he's had a problem for failing the dental resins because of the high corrosion. The patient will have the different corrosive salines. So that may be the particles, the gum particles coming out from the teeth. So to avoid that problem, the alternate material is butadiene strain. Butadiene strain is a high impact resin. It's incorporated with the glass and the carbon fibers and polyethylenes to make a composite and filling that. It gives the self-healing technology with the dental resins. It's a novel approach to solve the problem of failing dental resins. Then diamond fiber composite. The fiber tungsten wires coated with the polycrystalline diamonds using chemical vapor deposition method. So tungsten wires is 100 mm diameter is coated with the polycrystalline diamond using the method of chemical vapor deposition. The diamond coated wires are extremely stiff and rigid and can be embedded into the metal matrix to make a lightweight composite with the anisotropic property. Such materials have application in the aerospace industries, that is used in the ships and aerospace and all. Composite with the magnetic function. It is this magnetic function, again, the hollow fibers are inserted into the composites. Just what is happening that this tailoring the magnetic property into the composite, then you can monitor the structural, what is the life, any problem in that you can monitor. So like that, the magnetic micro ribbons and micro wires are being tailored and embedded into the macro composite material to provide magnetic sensing functions. Then aquatics. So aquatic solids, maybe you heard this news, aquatic solids. It is negative to the, it having the property like negative Poisson's ratio. When you are applying the pull in one direction, it expands all the directions. That is the property of aquatic solids. So using this, the composite material, foams and elastomers are provided for the aerospace and the naval and agronomic applications. You pull in this material, pull in one direction, it expands in all direction. That is the property of the aquatic materials. The use of smart material technology and the negative Poisson's ratio solid has also led to develop the smart aquatics for activates sound management, vibroacoustics, and natural health monitoring. Natural health monitoring. These are the recent areas. You can concentrate. And once more, the very, very important slide is this one. Already we discussed that thermoplastic and thermosets. So thermosets, it's having very high stiffness compared to the thermoplastics. But thermosets having a major drawback of recyclable. Now it is non-recyclable one. So you would avoid the usage of thermosets. Instead of, you can use the thermoplastics with improved quality, because that this slide shows that damaged component is can be again, it is replaced, that is recycled and then reusable. This is an example of carbon fiber reinforced polymers life cycle loop. So this is very useful to the community. So you can think it in that way. With this words, I conclude this session. Thank you. And the summary of this classification of compost have been studied. Characteristics of the composite are discussed. Application of the compost material have been discussed. Recent advances in the composite are addressed. Any questions? Please ask. Thank you. So these are the latest trends. So how we are replacing that alloy into the composite material. So I have quoted some examples. Okay, I will share the material. Thank you for your feedback. See, the aquatic solids, it's the example, the foams, using that foams, they are nowadays is a manufacturing a shoes. its foam is used in a controlled atmosphere, the controlled shape atmosphere. They can apply the load in one direction, it is pulled and occupy that, that it create a source. So that is the one of the simple example. Okay, so you want that, you can more, you can go to search in the web.
Sir, can we close the session, sir?
Yes, yes, sir. Answer the questions raised by the participants.
Okay, sir. Sir, one more question is there.
Okay. Tell me.
Which composite material having less thermal conductivity?
Less thermal conductivity. We cannot say that particularly, because the fiber having a different thermal expansion and the particle having different thermal expansion. We cannot roughly say that which composite will have the less thermal conductivity. So based on the reinforcement we are using, that we can achieve that thermal expansion characters.
Okay, sir, thank you.
Thank you.
So can we wait for some more questions?
Okay, no problem, sir.
So one more question is from Abid Ali. Suggest topic for newly entering in PhD in composites.
So in this, my suggestion is you can go for the polymer matrix composites. So the polymer matrix composite having the huge potential, as well as the new novelty in that research. So you can try the different combinations based on your requirements. You can get a better material in the fiber reinforcement composites.
Okay, sir. Nice, sir.
Okay. I want to thank the management, the principal of Saint College of Engineering and Technology, Pandruti, and I'll thank the HOD of Mechanical Engineering, Dr. D. Murugadasan, and my friend, Mr. T. Ilangovan. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
So, again, good morning to all of you. After successful completion of this wonderful session, I very much happy to propose vote of thanks to all of you. Really, I want to thank the participants. They are showing a wonderful cooperation for the past 5 days international webinar series. First, my heartfelt thanks to Dr. V. Satish Kumar, sir, for accepting our invitation and gave a wonderful presentation about composite materials. Because I also did the PhD in composites. More than that, I learned today with the help of Dr. V. Satish Kumar, sir. On behalf of management, principal, and participants, and my own behalf, I convey my heartfelt thanks to our resource person, Dr. V. Satish Kumar, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much, sir.
I extend my sincere thanks to our management and the principal for giving permission to conduct this 5 days international webinar series in this wonderful occasion. Thank you to our management and the principal. And I extend my sincere thanks to all the participants for this 5 days international webinar series, because they show wonderful cooperation throughout the webinar series, and also they shared valuable comments to make ourselves in excel in future. So on behalf of our management, principal, and the Department of Mechanical, and my own behalf, I extend my heartfelt thanks to all the participants. I want to thank our department faculties from my heart, bottom of my heart, because they have showed the excellent cooperation for this 5 days international webinar series held in successful manner. A special thanks to Mr. Bala Bhaskar, Assistant Professor, Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering. He is the web designer of this 5 days international webinar series. He done an excellent job, and then timely he sent all the replies to all the participants and intimation emails and SMS to all the participants. My heartfelt thank to Mr. Bala Bhaskar. Last but not least, I express my sincere thanks to all the participants participated with this 5 days international webinar series. Once again, I thank you all. Anything you want to rectify your problems, kindly come to the chat box. Thank you one and all. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.